Okay, here we are. A second video. This video here, if you listened to the last one, I was kind of stumbled at the end there because I wanted to show something that I didn't get at. So I'm going to actually make another one here. And hopefully this one gets my point across a little bit better. Watch the other one first because I go through some concepts of why these things change, particularly counting the same thing, okay? Watch this one as well. This one here, we go through why I make common denominators or how I'm counting those groups of 1/4, okay? In this video here, I'm just going to use a friendlier number. Friendlier numbers where we can actually get a nice answer. And an answer we can physically see in the model too. Okay, so let's look at this one. I have something easy. 1/3 is split up into 1/5. Okay, for this one, I can do the model. With the model, I'm going to actually draw in here is 1, and let's just 1/3. So 1 out of the 3, and I'm going to split this now up into fifths. Well, I can split this up into fifths by going here is 1. Here is 2, 3, and here is 4. 4 lines mean 5 sections, okay? Now, if we look at here, 1/3, so here's my 1/3, is the same as 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 5/15. Okay, and that's why what happens when we make common denominators, this one is going to be multiplied by 5, this one's going to be multiplied by 3. Usually, the one of the easiest ways to do it is just multiply by the opposite denominator. When we multiply by the opposite denominator, we're going to get a common denominator. And we can see here, my 3 is split up into 5s. So here, all this is the same as 5/15 is now going to be split up into groups of 3/15. Okay, so we can see here, I have my 5/15, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 out of 15, right? I'm now going to make groups of 3/15. Well, if I have 15ths and 15ths, I don't need to keep on saying 15ths, 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 15ths. We understand that concept. It's just like if I have groups of 5 dogs, I have 5 dogs, make groups of 3 dogs. Do I have to say dogs, dogs, dogs every time? No, I can just say I have 5, I want to make groups of 3. So here we can actually scratch out those denominators. We don't really need them anymore. And we just deal with I have 5 things, and I want to make groups of 3. When we have this one, it's always great to rewrite our division as a fraction. Moving forwards, most of the time you should want to or probably want to write your division as a fraction because it's conceptually just makes a little bit more sense. What this is saying is how many 3s go into 5, or 5 is split up into groups of 3, or 5 is shared amongst 3 equal groups. Most of the time we're looking at groups of 3. How many groups of 3 are there in 5? Well, there is 1 group of 3 in 5. If I take out that group of 3, that's the same as taking away 3. How much is left over? Well, 2 is left over out of my group of, what am I counting? I'm counting groups of 3. And let's look at the model. Let's see if this matches up here. Do I have my 5? Here are my 5. I want to make a group of 3. 1, 2, 3. Here is a group of 3. I'll grab a black pen for this one. 1, 2, 3. There's my group of 3. I have 1 group of 3. Now, what's left over? 1, 2. So I have 1 group of 3 with 2 left over out of my group of 3. And that's just like here. How many 3s are there in 5? There's 1 with 2 left over. And so we have a match up there. All right? And this works for any 2 fractions. And we can build them up to more complicated mixed numbers and all that. And what will happen is it will be the same concept just extrapolated to larger and more holes. Okay. If you want help with those mixed numbers ones, watch the next video with that. If you need help some more after that, hit me up and I'll help you as best I can. I'll catch you next video. Bye now.